The next presentation will be higher education reform and the next generations of MOOC by Professor Tsuneo Yamada. I would like to give you the profile of Professor Tsuneo Yamada, who is now a professor of, at the Department of Informatics and Center for Open and Distance Education, the Open University of Japan. He is also a professor of Department of Cyber Society and Culture at the Graduate University for Advanced Studies. His main research fields are informatics, educational technology, learning psychology, second language learning, and international volunteer studies. He has been engaged both in the study on advanced use of information and communication technology in educational fields and in the development of various multimedia learning content for second language learning, teacher education, and informatics education using new technologies such as DVD, web, MOOC, and speech technologies. Distinguished participants, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Professor Tsuneo Yamada.
Sawadee krap. So thank you very much, very kind introduction, Chairperson. And it's a great honor and pleasure for me to have a presentation and to share our experiences with you today. So I'd like to introduce our progress in JMOOC and also our institution, Open University of Japan MOOC. So at first, what is MOOC? But many speakers have already introduced MOOC, so maybe I need not to explain more. So a massive open online course, but MOOC is not only a scalable learning management system, but we think a total solution, some kind of a total solution to realize openness and quality assurance at once in sustainable way using IT and big data science. So so in Japan, we have a kind of association of academic CIO, so we call it AXIS. So this is a kind of EDUCOURSE in the United States. Somebody knows EDUCOURSE. But anyway, we have such kind of association of CIO and academic IT centers, center staffs. So we have annual conference every year, and I invited the keynote speaker from EDUCOURSE. So 2013 annual conference, we invite Professor Brian Boss, one of the executive EDUCOURSE board members, and he introduced MOOC to us. At that time, he using this slide, and dinosaurs our universities, and disruptive event, in this case, MOOCs. So they explain the existence of MOOCs in using this kind of figure. So at that time, we consider MOOC a new types of quality open educational resources, because this situation is not to change, but in our case, at that time in the globally also, dropout rate is very higher. So 80% to 90% and more people cannot finish the courses. So we consider MOOC one of the very special courses for a special person, so they can keep motivation and sufficient so abilities to continue the courses. But in the future, maybe technology improved such kind of situation. So we predict next step will be MOOC will be a new sustainable model of open education. So as I mentioned, my institution is Open University. So we considered open education, open university, only one sustainable model of open education for long years. But now MOOC emerged and show a new kind of open education models. So this is a real threat of open universities. But anyway, this is the second stage. And lastly, some people predict MOOCs will be a new model of higher education itself. So this is a real innovation. But the next year, so, but the situation is more complicated. So next year, we invited another EDUCOS board members, Professor Susan Metros from EDUCOS, who are our AXIS, so annual conference. At that time, she showed this slide. This is a slide of Gartner's hype cycle models. So 2013, so MOOCs that red point. But in the next year, 2014, no word shown in this hype cycles. So so in the considering the hype, so nobody anymore feel hype for MOOCs to 2014 in North America. But we knew at the same times in 2014 in many other countries except North America. We know just regional MOOCs were launching. So UNESCO and Open Up ED, European Union, so support African MOOC. And also, as explained later details, JMOOC was established in 2013, and Thai MOOC, K-MOOC, Indonesia MOOC, and China MOOC is our launching. And A-MOOC Community Summit was held in 2000, last year. And also AAOU, this is Asian Association of Open University, just launching Asian MOOC portal also. So in other areas, so still MOOC is very popular. And many countries try to launching MOOCs. And MOOCs showed new styles of education learning. So many speakers have already mentioned. So flipped classroom. And in our experience, many JMOOC courses use this kind of flipped classroom event the same time. And but in 2013, executive director IMS Global Learning Consortium, this is one of the international standardization organization in e-learning field, he mentioned MOOCs is one type of the blended learning. And as you know, so now MOOC has new features in different places. So in United States, a micro-credential-oriented MOOC. And so MOOC content and systems is now shared of open and proprietary education. So MOOCs and Spok is realized in the same platform sometimes. And the considering next generation of learning, digital learning infrastructure, so we should consider both MOOCs and other kind of e-learning, digital e-learning environment, learning environment. And we also be careful, so the movement in OER-oriented MOOC. So our organization is Open University, and we are very deep sympathy with open philosophy or open education movement. So we also the same. We have the same vector for the OER-oriented MOOC. So the situation is more complicated now. So we should consider both MOOC and Spok in a, if possible, one in a one paradigm or one framework. So typically, so EDUCOURSE and IMS Global Learning Standard, considering the next generation digital learning environment, they are try to share the vision and the possible architecture for the next step. So NGDLE, NGDLE, so we are just thinking, and the MOOC is one of the element of such kind of new infrastructure. And the dimension of the NGDLE. So NGDLE is very difficult to pronunciate, but president of EDUCOURSE, John O'Brien, is also it's very difficult to pronunciate for American people. So anyway, NGDLE. So has the dimensions, interoperability and integration, and personalization, analytics, advising, learning assessment, collaboration, accessibility, and universal design. So these are we should realize the next step. So our view at the moment, so it's just Japanese view. MOOC is an aspect, a phenotype of next generation ICT enhanced learning and education system for humans, not machines. Depending on ICT environment and learners' readiness, the system reorganizes the element, architecture, and the function in adaptive and scalable way. Maybe this idea is shared common with NGDLE. Sorry. So yesterday, Professor Stefan Downs mentioned, MOOC is not replaced with conventional higher education institutions, but maybe we should consider so some kind of a big wave is transforming higher education in broader and more invisible way. So MOOC is one of the aspect of our phenomena is such kind of a much bigger trend or something. So I'd like to show a couple of cases in Japan. So, 2013 was the first year of MOOC in Japan because University of Tokyo joined the Coursera February 2013, and Kyoto University joined EDX May 2013. And we launched JMOOC 2013 October. And And our organization is a non-profit and non-governmental organization. In Japanese, name translated directly, so General Incorporated Association. And we have, at the beginning, so we have no support from the government. This is a big difference from Korean case and Thai case. So we have, financially, we take the membership fee models. At the moment, we have 46 academic members, 7 public members, and 33 corporate members, and some alliance members. The purpose, strengthening our cooperation with businesses. Businesses mean corporate or industries, because we need the money from the industries. And we are very eager. We hope to have shared our many kind of resources with other countries also. So I have no. I have more time. Maybe 10 minutes past. Okay. So the second our view on MOOCs. So the historical roles MOOCs in Japan. So we think MOOC is the catalyst for the next generation ICT enhanced learning or education systems, which is applicable to developing areas and late majority, but a sort of late majority institutions. So we still think MOOC is a kind of test bed for late majority or adapters. In Japan, top university or big university can have their own IT centers and take care of their e-learning systems. But middle side or small side universities, they cannot maintain such kind of new technologies. So they need some kind of cloud academic services in this field also. But MOOC can be a more adequate testbed for such kind of newcomer. So I'll explain a couple of features or characteristics of a JMOOC. The one of the characteristics, we have multiple platforms. The currently, we have 4 platforms for MOOC. One is NTT Docomo platform, Gakko. NTT Docomo is one of the major mobile carrier in Japan. They provide OpenEdX-based MOOC platforms. And our university and a private university consortium TIES provide very special platforms. This is multimedia e-textbook based platforms. E-textbook means iBook. We have a iBook version, EPUB3 version. At the moment, we also have a web version also. So we have a 3 kind of the package for the content. And the third one is net learning. This is a private company in Japan. They also platform open learning. This is a domestic integrated learning support platforms. Then recently, Fujitsu, a very big computer company in Japan, so provide new MOOC platforms. This is a full web-based. They plan to have academic cloud services to Japanese universities. So to them, MOOC is one of the special services in such Japanese universities. The number of JMOOC provided by JMOOC in these figures. So 124 is not too many, but not too small for the result of three years. And the total enrollment, 580,000. This is JMOOC course, the humanity 25%, and computer science and programming 19%, business management 70%, social science 30%, and science 9%, and so on. What happened? Ah. So demography of the registrant. So so very equal among generations. So 20s, 30s, 40s, 50s, 60 and more are very equal numbers. And professions, full-time worker is 59%. And then they learn from using access from PC. And smartphone is like that. So I'd like to little bit so the relationship of higher education, the context, JMOOC in higher education reform context in Japan. So as I mentioned, so at the beginning, so we have no support from the government, but in the couple of contexts, so government to introduce MOOC activities. For example, MEXIT, Ministry of Education, basic plan of promoting education, it is published 2013. Basic major 8, this is on qualitative transformation of college education to establish self-directed autonomous learning by student. So in this context, so to facilitate active participation of university to open the university knowledge to the world and to improve quality of education through MOOCs or open educational resources. And this is also this is a report at a cabinet secretariat. So mentioned on educational, focusing on education reproduction practice. This is a very high ranked meetings under the prime minister. In the report, so MOOCs is also mentioned. Okay. And this is a project of Ministry of Education and the MITI. MITI is the Ministry of International Trade and Industries. They are just planning new training framework for the workers, and they decided to use our JMOOC platform also. So in universities also are considering how to reuse or remix of such MOOC materials also, but this is just a beginning in our country also. So some university plan to reuse the materials, MOOCs as the materials of other courses, and other university plan to use some kind of pre-entrance preparatory education or admission office examination, a part of AO, admission examination process. And I also introduce one of the JMOOC platform, OU JMOOC platforms. And our motivation is there. So I have already mentioned. So as an open university, so we'd like to examine the possibility of a MOOC in open education. So our university decided to MOOC platform providers in addition to MOOC course provider. So we launched OUJ MOOC platform. So this is the concept. So we are focusing on the the common area of learning management system and e-textbook, so digital textbook, and social networking services. And we also plan to big data collection and learning metrics and analytics, but this part is still developing. So the feature of our platforms are multimedia textbook, and we are running Moodles in backend at LMS. And we also utilize a couple of social networking services provided in public or commercially, so Facebook, YouTube, Mozilla Open Badge, and so on. And we also are making a learning log store. We are still considering which data standardization should be used. So IMS Caliper Analytics Standard or ADL Experience API. So we have our university not so rich, so we have no money. So we could not develop a MOOC platform from the scratch. So we use some kind of mashup, the given public services, and to make MOOC platforms. So we use Facebook for the registration or the information sharing with student. And as I mentioned, we used learning management Moodles as LMS. This is the open source software. We also use some kind of credit system, badge systems using modular open badges. And we put our contents, so iBook version of our textbook in iBook store, iTunes, and Android, so EPUB 3 digital textbook in Google Apps. So so users can download it from such kind of commercial services. And needless to say, we know some people hate these social networking services, so hate Facebook or hate YouTube. So we have launched our own servers in our university, and for such people to download from our own servers also. And we, the number of the course our OUJ provided is not so many, but I will introduce briefly one of the course, Nihongo, the Japanese language starter A1. So different from other courses, our lecturer is this kind of avatar. So we developed our courses as a team. So we gave up to you. So we use this kind of avatar. And another characteristics, our curriculum is based on competency models. As you may know, in language education areas, CIFR, a common European framework of reference for language. So this is we use common standard and to make curriculums. So left column is a lesson. The right one is can do mean a competence. So we consist, this course it consists of 10 lessons and 27 competencies. So the content is very interesting. So drama style skit we developed, and I have no time, maybe 3 minutes or 5 minutes, so I cannot show you today. But if you visit. This portals, you can download our digital textbook anytime. And we have, in this fiscal year, we plan to have 3 classes with the same contents. And now, class 8 is just finishing. Totally, we have 5,000 registrants. Big batch, so certificate holder is about between 5% and 10%. So dropout rate is still very high. So JMOOC had another meaning, joint MOOC. So as I mentioned, so we have in JMOOC platform, JMOOC consortium, we have 4 platforms. So and to realize high quality MOOC, so maybe we should develop well-tuned artificial intelligence or machine-supported systems, because the human, we cannot use so many human resources. So MOOC innovation in, brought us new types of open education and big data and learning analytics, and also the possibility of optimization, especially personalization learning processes, so under the support of machines. To realize such kind of functionality, we need many materials of the courses. So one of the, our the current concern is how to realize materials repositories. And another is big data fusion of big data science and so on. So I have no time, so I skipped. sorry. So I put our slide. 5 minutes? But he said 5 minutes. So 5 minutes. Okay. So as you are universities, we have many databases. So siloed database. So we need some kind of federation. A federation of academic or educational databases. So we have a student information system, we have many learning management systems, and library systems also, and sometimes federated identification system also. And anyway, so we have many database in our on campus. So we can utilize such kind of personal data for the improvement of the education or management. So to realize such kind of functions, we need some standardization of the data. But I cannot, so, and another point is, I should say this point. So we have four platforms in JMOOC. So we are now have just reached agreement these three platform providers to share the learning log data. So to realize to share the learning log data, we may be used IMS Caliper Analytics. Unfortunately, GACO platform used OpenEdX, so they cannot they cannot change the software learning log data data so collecting part so they by themselves so they should be a kind of observer, but we start how can realize such kind of data sharing systems among platforms. And materials repositories, we have very common framework using librarian systems. In Japan, we have a gyro system. This is harvesting systems of institutional repositories. So using same framework, so we try to realize such kind of materials repository functions. The internationally, so we have a Globe Consortium. This one, Global Learning Object Brokered Exchange. This consortium was established 15 years ago, and Melro, Thai Cyber University also a member. But currently, we have no activities, actually. But we I'd like to make a proposal to reuse this metadata systems for materials repositories. So maybe I used most of time. So we hope Thai Cyber University and we, in addition to sharing of MOOC course information, have not only such kind of course information, but a new sharing, different levels of sharing of materials, such as materials or applications or sometimes data in the future. So thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you so very much, Professor Tsuneo Yamada. Since we are a bit behind the schedule, so I would like to seek your cooperation. I'll come back to you this grand hall at 10:45, so we can start the next session on time. Thank you.